y'all in here to worship him. To worship the first beast who doesn't mean what's real. He's playing the part. Satan is not flesh and blood. The Antichrist is not flesh and blood. He is a supernatural being. And he doeth great wonders so that he make it come down from heaven and earth, make fire come down from heaven and earth in the sight of men. And I'm going to tell you what he's trying to imitate. I told you Satan is an imitator. He imitates everything from God and the children of God. There is no greater power than the power of God. And in the book of 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 23 and 24. This is what Elijah said to the children because they were divided. Jesus, God, who do you serve? Should you serve Baal or should you serve God? To God be the glory. It says, let them therefore give us two bullocks. That is in 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 23 and 24. And let them choose one bullock for themselves and cut it in pieces and lay it on the wood and put no fire under. And I will dress the other bullock and lay it on the wood and put no fire under. And call you on the name of your gods. And I will call on the name of the Lord. And the God that answered by fire, let him be God. And all the people answered and said, it is well spoken. So Satan is going to imitate the prophet Elijah. This is what he's going to do. It says, he exercises wonders so that he make a fire come down from heaven, just like Elijah in the book of 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 23 and 24 on the earth in the sight of men, and deceive them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, in the sight of the system. It's a system, saying to them that dwell on the earth, those who did not repent from their sin and those whose name is not written in the book of life. When will she have a wound by a sword and they live? Now, let me break it down to you. The word of God is a sword. The sword that come out your mouth is the word of God. Because it's cut. So let's speak spiritually, not a physical soul, but a testimony. When you be delivered, you're going to testify against the Antichrist. Because he's going to cease to throw you into jail, but he can't kill you. He cannot touch not one hair of your head. And it says here, and he has power to give life unto the image of the beast. The system is going to be set up. Well, right now, you see the images. You see the images of the skull and bones and the wings, the angelic wings, and all the t-shirts, the scarf, all the logos. Those are the things from the secret societies. You see the triangle, the triquetra. You see all the people that are putting these tattoos on their bodies and wearing these garments that carry in the things of satanic one world order, Raj's cult. And they don't know that they're putting their money into the beast system, into an image that is going to program their mind to receive the mark of the beast. So they're using the symbols and the scenes from their logics and their cult, and they're using the movie stars, and they're using all of the singers and the rappers, and they're using these symbols because they're also in the one world order of that satanic society. And Christians need to be aware that these symbols bring curses on them. They need to take these symbols off of their head, off of their belt, and throw it. They're worshiping the goat. They got some singers and actresses dressing up in the purple in the little jackets. That jacket have a meaning. Dr. Pepper jacket have a meaning, which is one of the known Satanists in the whole world. and these artists are worshipping Dr. Pepper. And you see that this is the image of the beast. That when it says here in verse 15 of Revelation chapter 13, and he had the power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as will not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Is a separation. Are you willing? Because the word of God does say, you try to save their life, but you lose their soul. You gotta make a stand in the spiritual warfare. Let the fear go from you, because God has not given you the spirit of fear, but power of love and sound mind. Verse 16. And he called all both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive the mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. To receive the mark in your forehead means that you already believe in the rapture doctrine. Those who believe in the rapture and teach the rapture. Those who are in the system of the lodges, the big G's, the little G's, the Easterners, the Eastern Stars. Those people who believe in the system, those people who in the New Age, who are Satanists, are we worshiping all kind of traditional religions, all of them are under the same umbrella. And those people worship the false God, they have already received the mark of the beast. From Obia, Shango, Santeria, Bueria, Kekalema, adultery, homosexuality, those people have already got the mark of the beast. And it's going to come a time that you're going to see the seas open up, and you're going to see the vials being poured up, and you're going to vividly be able to see them full of souls and conquer worms, and you're going to see them that they're going to be sick, and they're going to try to kill themselves, and they will not die, and they'll try to jump for a billion, and when they jump, they're not going to die. Because in the days of old, when Cain murdered his brother Abel, God put a mark upon Cain. Wherever Cain went, it was visible for them to see that mark. And some people who are spiritual can see a spiritual mark on others. It's called the gift of discernment of spirit. Some of us are born with it. And some of them have to go and send their soul to Satan. They call them Obiaman. And it said here, to close out in this chapter, verse 18. Here is the wisdom. Let him that has understanding count the number of the beast. For its number of a man, and its number is 666. Now, let me break it down to you. The 6 day creation is when God created man. So it's linked to mankind. But you have to understand the season. You got the 16, that's when you're going to present, the 6th trumpet, and the 6th vial. When you read in the Bible, in the book of Revelation, you mark where it says 6th trumpet, 6th vial, and 6th seal. And it's linked to verse 18 in Revelation 13. This is what it's telling you. It is a symbolic code that God puts in the Word of God so you can understand. Like that is the Antichrist. Who is the Antichrist? Read Revelation 20, verse 2 to 4. Revelation 12, 9. Now we're going to go back now to the book of Daniel, chapter 9. And we're living in perilous times. And some people are so caught up on their self that they believe that anything will happen here, we're going to be okay. So I'm urging the children of God to start praying, and let us pray the prayer of Daniel. In the first year of Darius, the son of Ahasuerus, the seed of me, which was made king over the realm of the Chaldeans, in the first year of his reign, I, Daniel, understood by books the number of the years whereof the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah the prophet. He even prophesied about the captivity.